Hello there, welcome back. It's Billy Ashbaugh here. We're at the Drum Room again with DrummerConnection.com. In today's lesson, we're going to actually learn to understand how to read and write and properly play eighth note triplets. Compared to 16th notes, I view it as a trade-off. When it comes to reading the notation, okay, these computer-generated notes, dots and rest, eighth note triplets are much, much easier because you really only have to memorize how to read eighth note or eighth note rest. However, 16th note, to read them can be a lot more difficult with the dots and just all the different combinations. So it's easier in that sense. However, it's a little more difficult to actually be able to play these notes properly. So what we're going to do is slow it way down. I'm going to start out on the pad. And remember, we're looking at one quarter note or one beat, and we're looking at the possibilities that we have within those three notes. We could play just the first, just the second, just the third, the first two, and so on. So if you combine the quarter note and the quarter note rest to this, we only have five more to look at, so let's get started. Okay, our first combination is going to be simply the last triplet of the beat. So here's what that sounds like. Three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet. Next up, we're going to do the first and last triplet. This is our first two-note combination. This is a shuffle pattern. I'm sure you'll recognize this. Here's what it sounds like. Three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, one. Now things are going to get fun. We're going to do the middle triplet. We're going to start off with just the middle triplet. Just that single hit sounds like this. Three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet. Next up, just the last two triplets. Sounds like this. Three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet. And finally, we're going to look at the first two triplets. Sounds like this. Three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet, one triplet, two triplet, three triplet, four triplet. Now it's time to have some fun. First thing you have to do is go to drummerconnection.com/drum lessons and check out the download tab underneath the window where you're watching this lesson. You want to print that PDF file, grab it, and get it in front of you because now we're going to have some fun. What we're going to do is start to look at putting these combinations together. But as always, we're going to slow this down and we're just going to loop it. We're going to start with the very first measure and loop it and get it comfortable, and then we'll move our way through the line and down the page. So now, before we even get started, let's talk through this first measure, see what we got going on. There is a quarter note for beat one, last triplet of beat two, another quarter note on beat three, and again another last triplet on beat four. Now it's time to look at line one. What I'll do is I'll play each measure two times and then I'll move on. Okay, now let's look at the first measure, the second line. Let's talk through what's going on first before we try and play it. First and last triplet of beat one, quarter note on beat two, first and last triplet for three, and again the first and last triplet for beat four. And here's a look at line two. All right, the first measure of line three looks like this. We have the middle triplet of beat one, quarter note for beat two, middle triplet for beat three, and another quarter note for beat four. Here's an example of line three. Remember, you're going to hear each measure two times, and then I'll move on. Okay, line four is next. The first measure, let's talk through it as always. We have the last two triplets of beat one, last two triplets of beat two, quarter note on beat three, and the first and last triplet for beat four. And now here's line four. Finally, let's look at line five, the last one on the sheet. First measure, let's talk through this guy, as always. First two triplets for beat one, first and last triplet for beat two, the first two triplets again on beat three, and the first and last triplets on beat four. And as always, here's line five as written two times through each measure. And there you go, your introduction to reading eighth note triplets. Remember, there's only five combinations, five possibilities, combined with the quarter note and quarter note rest, and it's not a reading thing, as you can tell, it's more just a feel thing. So as always, be patient, don't be afraid to slow it down. I've said it a million times, but if you slow it down, internalize it, then when you speed it up, all those notes stay in place, and next thing you know, you're grooving like a professional drummer. So you guys have fun, be sure and check back, we got a lot more triplet stuff heading your way. Thanks.